General Stahl, what a wonderful surprise. It is always a pleasure to welcome.
Silence! How dare you speak of pleasure when my rocket lies in pieces?
Pieces, General? I don't understand.
How dare you pretend you have not heard? That idiot who runs Stalag Luft may as well have called in the bombers himself.
This is grave news indeed, Herr General. But perhaps I can offer something to at least partially alleviate the pain.
Guard? You!
Please, Herr General, I mean to say, we have not yet debriefed the prisoner.
You stole my plans from Stalag Luft. You somehow arranged the destruction of my rocket, and now, Englander, you will pay the price.
Given the chance, General, I'd have strapped you to that rocket and lit the touch paper.
Herr General!
What is the meaning of this? Wait a minute. I remember you. You were in Stalag Luft. So, you tried to escape in my car? Only to end up inadvertently transferring yourself straight into another prison camp? This is most amusing! Is that not amusing, Commandant?
What should I do with this man, Herr General?
Oh, take him to join the others inside and give him extra rations. He has brightened up my day considerably.
And prisoner Harding, Herr General?
Throw him in the cooler. I will deal with him later.
Ah, it is of course most agreeable to be reacquainted with you, Captain Stone. But it grieves me to think that a man of your courage is likely to spend the rest of the war behind bars.
I bust out of this place once. Don't see why I couldn't do it again.
Might not be quite that simple, Stone. You see, Jerry seems to have rather upped the ante.
Oh yeah?
We've concocted one scheme after another and planned them in meticulous detail.
Merely for us to be foiled by the Germans each time at the penultimate moment.
Only fellow to make any sort of headway was the SOE chap, Harding. Decided to go it alone. Didn't seem to trust anyone. Wouldn't even tell us what he was up to. Just kept disappearing off up into the attic above the chapel.
The attic, huh? Guess I could go check it out.
Indeed, Captain. Colonel Harding has been removed from the picture, but we might perhaps salvage something of his work, no?
Mum's the word, though, eh, Stone? We're not quite sure who can be trusted just now.
Thought you looked familiar. I'll tell you, I'm finding it harder and harder to lay my hands on any stock around these parts. But give me a try anyway, won't you?
Nothing lights my fire just now, Johnson.
Well, you can't blame a man for trying. Maybe next time, huh?
Captain Stone, is it? I was expecting you to be, taller. Sir, I am Bernier, your new roommate. I hope we will become good friends, sir. People say I am a good listener.
You're new around here, ain't you, Bernier? Been here long?
Oh, not long, sir. Perhaps 2 weeks. But it appears I will be here a while. The Germans have done an excellent job of making this place escape-proof. Would you not agree?
Oh, yeah? You tried anything?
Me? Why would I? I mean, what is the purpose, sir? With General Stahl around, you cannot blink without the Germans knowing about it. Look at Harding. He tried to escape and now he's in solitary for good.
You must have some idea how to get out of here, don't you?
Not me, sir. Perhaps you should ask Doc Winters. He knows this place inside out. Oh, and should he tell you anything useful, perhaps you would let me know, eh? I find the business of escape most fascinating.
How are you finding life in Colditz?
Oh, I think people complain too much, you know? Some of the food here is actually quite tasty.
I'll speak to you later.
Just couldn't stay away, sir, is that it? I'm telling you, if you're thinking of busting out again, you can forget it. It's like the guards have gotten some sixth sense.
Will you help me, Barati?
This is always an embarrassing subject, sir, but, well, for the small sum of 25 currency, me, Williams, and Logan could be a big help to you.
I'll speak to you later.
Back so soon, my friend? Yeah, I'm still here. We all are. It's not for lack of trying, but the guards always seem to be one step ahead of us. Personally, I've given up. Colditz can keep me.
Say, Doc, you ever managed to get into the attic of the chapel?
No. My sneaking around days are over. But if they weren't, well, I might try the library.
But ain't the library still off limits?
Ah, very true. They keep the door by the escape committee's room locked. And I don't know any other way in.
Guess I'll have to borrow Kapowski's lockpick again, then.
Kapowski? They shipped him out of here a couple of days ago. Don't know where to. Took his lockpick with him. Only way through the door now is a brass key. And the guards keep hold of those.
Where am I gonna find a brass key?
I admire your determination, my friend. But I imagine they'd keep a brass key in the administration office. And that's heavily guarded.
Got anything else for me?
Not at present. But I'll sure keep my eyes open.
I'll speak to you later.
A fellow flyer, eh? Good to meet you. The name's Crown. Rotten being brought down to Earth like this, isn't it? I was on Spit. Clipped the wings of six Huns before the rotters punched a hole in my fuel tank over Antwerp.
And you've been in here how long?
Only a couple of weeks. But with yours truly out of the picture, I bet the skies are fast filling up with 109s and Focke-Wulfs. What I'd give to be back in the cockpit.
Have you tried making a run for it?
Have I? Huh. I'm taking a shot at practically every scheme the escape committee can muster. But just when we think we've got away with it, there's Jerry with all that Hander-Hoch nonsense. Really is most frustrating.
How many kills did you say you had?
Half a dozen so far. That's just fighters, of course. I don't count Hankels and the like. Far too easy.
I'll speak to you later.
Delighted to see you again, sir. And most terribly sorry, of course. Jerry's tightened everything up somewhat since your last visit. The Commandant seems to have been thrown into quite a spin by the General.
Have I missed much while I've been gone, Worthington?
Very little, to be honest, sir. In fact, while you and Harding have been away, the escape committee has been rather stuck in a rut. They tried some brilliant wheezes, but every time Jerry's twigged at the last moment. It really is most demoralizing.
How come? Did they catch you at it too?
Alas, they did. I'd hatched a scheme to disguise myself as the postman, knock him over the head as he made his delivery, and pedal off down the road on his bicycle. I'd spent 2 weeks perfecting my Reichspost uniform.
And what happened?
Never even got the chance to try it on. They burst into the barracks one day and found it under my mattress, practically the first place they looked. I got 4 days in the cooler for that.
Why all the heavy security?
I really couldn't say, sir. Though I'm endeavoring to find out. I'm convinced it has something to do with the General.
I'll speak to you later.
Hello there!
And you've been in here how long?
Only a couple of weeks, but with your...
I'll speak to you later.
Welcome back, Captain.
I'll bet you're hatching some kind of scheme again already. So maybe we should help each other out.
Can you lend a hand with a crouch?
Look, Captain, how's about we cut a deal? Me, Logan, and Baratti can give you a hand. But we'd like 25 currency first if we're gonna stick our necks out for you.
I'll speak to you later.
I see you so little, Captain. Keeping yourself busy, eh?
I'll speak to you later.
This is always an embarrassing subject, sir, but, well, for the small sum of 25 currency, me, Williams, and Logan could be a big help to you.
Takes more than that to embarrass me. Here, take the 25.
You know it makes sense, sir. We won't be far away if you need us.
I'll speak to you later.
Take a look at my stock list, why don't you? I sure could use the business.
Nothing lights my fire just now, Johnson.
Well, can't blame a man for trying. Maybe next time, huh? Captain?
I'll speak to you later.
I hope your work proceeds satisfactorily, mon ami.
I'll speak to you later.
Getting on all right, Stone.
I'll speak to you later.
Again, huh? I wouldn't bank on getting out so easily this time. The Krauts are a lot smarter than they used to be.
I'll speak to you later.
Hello there!
I'll speak to you later.
Hello, sir.
I'll speak to you later.
You been back to Stalag Luft, Captain? You been playing dice with that no-good swindler, Mickey Malone? Was I right about him, or was I right?
Yeah, you were right.
You want to try a little card game, Captain? Come and see me in the afternoon free time.
I'll speak to you later.
Could you use some help, Captain?
I'll speak to you later.
Back again, eh, sir? Gosh! Well, perhaps the breaker's sharpened the old aim. I'll still run my little sideshow here, so do drop in sometime and try your luck.
You can count on it.
If you fancy a game, sir, come and find me during morning exercise or afternoon free time.
I'll speak to you later.
Thank you.
when I find you.
Thank you.
Wakey, wakey, gentlemen. Let us all be on our best behavior once again today.
Harding might be short on manners, but he sure got a few tricks up his sleeve. Wait till I tell the escape committee boys about this. The door is locked. Locked. Thank you.
hope your work proceeds satisfactorily, mon ami.
I've worked out Harding's plan, Group Captain.
Ah, this is most welcome news, mon ami. Let us speak further in private.
A glider? You must be imagining things.
I know my airplanes, Major, and this one looked pretty real to me.
Well, I'll be blowed. Old Harding, eh? You're a pilot, Captain Stone. In your opinion, would this glider be airworthy?
It could use a little more work. The wings want bracing properly, the rudder needs a control cable, and there's some fabric missing from one of the wings. But yeah, I reckon she'd fly.
Remarkable. If we could get this thing in the air, it'd be the escape story of the century.
I agree. Colonel Harding's efforts should not have been in vain. Captain, do what you can to finish this aircraft, but a word of caution. The Germans' recent success in foiling our plans leads us to just one conclusion, that we have been infiltrated by a spy.
You don't say.
Your first priority should be to establish the name of the man who betrays us. We assume he must report his findings to the Commandant in his quarters. This should give you a chance to identify him. Also, Captain, we require proof to show the other men. Do you know how to use a camera?
Are you kidding? Reconnaissance is a specialty of mine.
Wakey, wakey, gentlemen! Let us all be on our best behavior once again today.
Thank you.
Guten Tag.
Getting on all right, Stone.
I'll speak to you later.
I don't recognize you.
Halt! Prisoner!
Let us hope you're not afraid of the dark, Captain.
Hello, sir.
How can I get a look into the Commandant's quarters?
You certainly ask some posers, sir. Only route I've heard about is through Jerry's area, just off the corridor between the mess hall and the kitchen. But I gather there's probably a patrol right outside. Sounds like more trouble than it's worth, sir.
Oh? What would you do instead?
I'd steer clear of the whole place, sir. But should one be dead set on taking a peek? I've heard Jerry mention a balcony outside the Commandant's room. We're very much in the dark about the whole area, to be honest, though, sir.
I can use some planks right now, Worthington. You seen any?
Funny enough, sir, I have. Not sure if you've noticed how Jerry's been levering open old doors, but they've dumped the leftover planks in the chapel. Don't know if they're still there, though.
Did you talk to the new boys?
Oh, yes, sir. Crown seems terribly keen to get back into his cockpit, and Bernier, well, I'm still trying to get the measure of him. Seems a decent enough sort of fellow, though.
I'll speak to you later.
Your wish is my command, sir.
I'll speak to you later.
Captain?
I'm looking to get into the Commandant's quarters. Any ideas?
Well, I used to go in through our mess hall, and then the guards' mess. But that can be tricky these days. You might do better to find another way, my friend.
Have you met the new inmates?
Bernier and Crown? Ah, they seem pleasant enough. Bernier's a strange one, but at least he shows an interest. As for Crown, I hear he's been invaluable to the escape committee.
Say, you know where I could find a decent bed sheet?
They don't call it cold its for nothing, eh, my friend? I'd imagine the guards sleep rather more soundly than we do.
I'll speak to you later.
Take a look at my stock list, why don't you? I sure could use the business. Sorry, Captain. I'm all out. Times are hard at the moment, as I'm sure you can understand. Why not check back later? In the meanwhile, are you sure there's nothing I can tempt you with?
I'll speak to you later.
Thank you.
Wakey, wakey, gentlemen. Let us all be on our best behavior once again today.
Thank you.
What was that noise? And this prisoner has been distilling the substance himself.
That is correct, Herr Commandant. But after I alerted the guards, his equipment was removed and destroyed.
Excellent work, Captain Zimmermann. Oh, and did you by any chance discover who defaced my photograph of Otto?
Yes, Herr Commandant. The culprit is...
Was is the meaning of this? Collusion with the prisoners? Guards, arrest both these men!
One moment, Herr General. It is not how it seems. This man is one of us.
Explain.
With your permission, Herr Commandant. I was just reporting to the Commandant that the prisoners have been illicitly supplementing their rations with scrapings from the officers' dustbins. And also that one man has been manufacturing a forbidden beverage in his barracks. Jolly devious, what?
Well, Commandant, if those are the worst of the prisoners' crimes, perhaps security at Kolditz is not so bad as I had feared.
Indeed, Herr General. Since we placed prisoner Harding in solitary confinement, we have had little, if any, trouble.
Harding. I want that man watched at all times. If he so much as sneezes out of turn, he is to be shot.
With respect, Herr General, to execute a British officer without due cause would be...
Commandant, would you rather he wandered freely into the laboratories beneath the castle and sent phase two of the program up in flames as well?
Of course not, Herr General.
Sir, there was one other thing. I noticed a prisoner leaving the authorized area and moving in a furtive manner above the library. I took the liberty of photographing the incident and have the film here.
Probably just harmless mischief. We will tighten security around the library.
It is all on this film, sir.
Oh, give it to me.
We won't let on to Crown that we've blown his cover just yet. But we'll warn the other prisoners to watch what they say around him. I thought that fellow smelt a bit fishy. Never liked the cut of his jib.
And that ain't all. The general said something about more laboratories under the castle.
Oh, this is most interesting. Oh, I suspected we had not seen the last of General Stahl's scientific ambitions. Oh, Captain, you must finish the glider with all haste and then see what you can discover in the foundations of Kolditz.
We've had this steel key made up for you, Stone. It might prove useful.
Wakey, wakey, gentlemen! Let us all be on our best behavior once again today.
Do not obstruct me, American, or you will be sent to the cooler.
About Crown?
I did. Don't let on though, will you? Perhaps we can have a little fun with him.
I'm looking for a sheet. Needs to be a good one. Any ideas?
Ah, yes. Harding's little project. Ingenious. Well, if it's the finest bed linen you want, I'd go look in the guards' barracks.
I'm hunting for some planks, Doc. You seen any lying around?
Planks? Not me. You could try Worthington.
Doc, you know where I can find me some electrical cable?
Now, it's funny you should ask that. I was talking to Bernier, and he mentioned something about cable.
I'll speak to you later.
Take a look at my stock list, why don't you? Sure could use the business.
Nothing lights my fire just now, Johnson.
Well, can't blame a man for trying. Maybe next time, huh?
Your wish is my command, sir.
I'll speak to you later.
I see you so little, Captain. Keeping yourself busy, eh?
Hey, Bernier, did you hear about Crown?
You know, I always thought Crown looked a little suspicious. However, we should not discuss this further. The escape committee asked us to let him believe we are unaware of his true identity.
Why the saggy eyes, Bernier?
I am not sleeping so well, sir. I am constantly woken by the most curious noises coming from below. It really is most distressing.
I've got to find some electrical cable, and fast. Got any ideas?
Actually, sir, I have. I noticed the guards carrying some cable into an attic storeroom. I think it was left over from the work they are doing on the theater lighting. However, they locked the door behind them with a steel key.
Have you seen a steel key?
You know, sir? I'm sure I have. Yes, I can see it now. It was in the chapel. There was a steel key on top of a box, and beside the box, a guard.
I'll speak to you later. What'll it be? I'll speak to you later.
there.
How you doing, Crown?
Twiddling my thumbs a bit at the moment, to be honest. The escape committee hasn't given me much to do. Must be all out of ideas.
Been to the German side of the castle recently?
What? No, I haven't. Love to, of course, but the mess hall route's been proving rather tricky recently. Perhaps you've tried it yourself.
I'll speak to you later.
Hello, sir.
Did they fill you in about Crown?
They did.
Dreadful business.
You mustn't let Crown know we're onto. Better the devil you know, the EC says. But when I think about the number of my schemes he's unraveled, it's hard to resist simply punching him on the nose.
Got any plans to get out of here, Worthington?
Naturally, sir. But I've decided to keep them to myself after the business with Crown. No offense intended, of course.
I'm trying to find me some planks. You able to help?
You might try the chapel, sir. Jerry's been breaking open some old boarded-up doors, and they've dumped the debris in there.
I'll speak to you later.
Could you use some help, Captain?
I'll speak to you later.
Schnell!
Thank you.
cause that noise.
Thank you.
forever. You cannot hide forever.
That should just about do it.
Oh.
I am delighted that you all conducted yourselves so admirably today. Let us keep it that way.
Oops.
Hände hoch! Hände hoch! Schnell!
If not Harding, then who? We have reviewed the records of all the prisoners and singled out a second inmate. This man was present first during the stealing of the plans from Stalag Luft, and then again during the destruction of the rocket.
Probably just a coincidence. Harding is the one behind all this. I know it.
General, there is one other thing. This second prisoner was involved in an escape from Kolditz, which was not reported.
What?
The prisoner was recaptured near Stalag Luft and later admitted there. It was recorded as a routine transfer from Kolditz, so that, General, as you are aware, this castle has previously had an unblemished record. And,
you covered this up?
If I may, General, the picture I took above the library has been developed.
What? This cannot be.
The prisoner's name is Stone.
I will settle your fate later, Commandant.
Schnell!
It is overheating!
I cannot stabilize it!
Pull the lever, you idiot!
Friedrich, get outside.
The Commandant said I would be shot if I left my post.
The Commandant has changed his mind. He has called an emergency briefing in the courtyard. Quickly, come!
Is this getting easier, or am I just getting better?
It's reaching critical!
Prisoner Stone must be found and arrested at any cost. Is that understood?
General! The rocket!
General! It's gone critical!
We tried to stop it!
Sorry, Herr General!
Cancel that last order. Return to your posts. Captain Stone is to be shot on sight.
Was it something I said? Better get to the glider.
Nice handiwork, Stone. I'd love to know where you found the cable to rig up the rudder.
You got room for one more?
I may have built this thing, Captain, but you're the airman. Jump in.
Did you really think I was unaware of your little hobby, Captain Stone?
Guess I should thank Sergeant Crown, or should I say, Captain Zimmerman.
Yes, yes. So pathetically trustworthy, you Americans. You honestly thought you could create such a disturbance, make so much noise with your grand scheme that we would not notice? No, Americans, there will be no more prison camps, no more days in the cooler. For all the trouble you have caused, you will die.
Trouble? You have no idea what trouble is, Stahl. Let me tell you something. There's only one person dying here today, and it ain't me or Harding.
Ha! So confident! But you forget it is I who has the gun, and not you, my friend.
I know all about your damn gun, Stahl. It's the same one you used to kill my buddy, and I ain't your friend.
Your buddy? Ah, yes, I remember. He was a poor excuse for a soldier to attempt to run from me at Stalag Luft, wasn't he? Tell me, you did order him to stay? No matter. I will tell you this also. As I aimed this gun you love so much at his head, he begged me to spare his life. No dignity.
Go, Stone. I'll never make it in this state. But go. There are more ways out of here than this, Stone. Honestly, did you really think we told you everything? Huh.
Crazy Brit. So long, Harding. Good luck. That was for you, JD, my friend. Now where did you say those Fräuleins were at?